The Philippine government accused of bullying transport workers amid its firm refusal to extend the PUV franchise consolidation. Transport Group Manibela says government is not making an effort to heed their demands. It also slams plans to allow tricycles to ply the routes.
Di natin alam kung anong klaseng pag-iisip itong LTFRB ang ginagawa po nila. Isipin mo kung puro tricycle po ang pabibiyahin natin ng mas malayo doon sa original na, na ruta nila. Mas mahal po talaga, o doble hanggang triple po ang pamasahe po. Hindi po talaga nila mararamdaman yon. Nasa loob po sila sa opisina nila. Subukan po nila na mag-commute, o yung mga taong nagko-commute po, yung kanilang tatanungin kung kumusta po ang kanilang biyahe. Pangbubuli po sa atin ng gobyerno, grabe po talaga. Sobra-sobrang pahirap po ito sa ating mamamayan, hindi lamang po sa aming mga sa ating mga drivers at operator.
Another transport group, Piston, meanwhile maintains phasing out traditional jeepneys will severely affect the country's economy.
Yung malaking porsyento na halimbawa mawawala sa hanin ng ating public transport ay malaking epekto nga yan, hindi lamang sa hanin ng mga driver at operator, kundi sa ating mga mamamayan, mismo sa ating ekonomiya. Dahil ang sinasabi nga natin, kapag nagkaroon po ng transport crisis sa ating bansa, ang direct effect niyan ay yung ating yung mismo yung ating ekonomiya. Kaya tayo ay yung sinasabi halimbawa ng mga taga LTFRB, taga DOTR, sinasabi nila papayagan namin yung mga tricycle, papayagan namin ng mga kung magbibigay kami ng mga special permit. Ito ay bahagi ng pagpapakita na talagang hindi konkreto at hindi malinaw yung programa sa balangkas ng modernization, kundi ang nagiging pagtugon lamang ay parang papachipat yung solusyon, hindi doon sa matagalang.
Transport regulators confident government's public utility vehicle modernization program will not result in a transport crisis next year. This as jeepney operators scramble to comply with government's requirements, with a deadline just days away. Andrea Taguinas reports.
Raquel Magrata spent the whole day at the LTFRB Wednesday to process the consolidation requirements of the new members of their transport cooperative. She said around 100 jeepney operators and drivers joined their group in just the last few months.
Kasi sinasabi nga nila, deadline na ngayon.
This jeepney operator also came to apply for consolidation, even if she said it's against her will.
Ayaw talaga namin magpag-consolidate, kaso mapipilitan kami kasi hindi na kami makakabiyahe ng January. Paano yung mga anak namin?
The Office of Transportation Cooperatives also getting more visitors wanting to form a co-op. They are scrambling to beat the December 31, 2023 consolidation deadline set by the government to avoid having their franchise revoked come January 1, 2024. While 70% of public utility vehicles nationwide have already consolidated, according to no less than President Marcos, based on data from the LTFRB, only around 11,000 or 27% of jeepneys in the National Capital Region have undergone consolidation as of December 12. While just over 200 or 29% of routes are being operated by consolidated transport groups. The DOTR expects these figures to grow further by the end of the month so that there will still be a sufficient number of PUVs to serve commuters next year. But even if not all are able to catch the consolidation deadline, the DOTR and the LTFRB are not worried about a possible transport crisis, which transport groups Piston and Manibela have repeatedly warned about. In a statement, the DOTR pointed out that all major routes and thoroughfares, at least in NCR, are being operated by consolidated transport groups. As for secondary routes, it said these can be served by other modes of public transport like buses and tricycles. Consolidated PUVs will also be allowed to apply for special permits to ply routes that may face a shortage. That's on top of their existing routes. Local government units will also play a role in ensuring sufficient public transport services, as well as in the next phase of the PUV modernization program. The LTFRB is working with LGUs on route rationalization, or the planning of local routes based on passenger demand. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine government receives proposals from four groups for the Ninoy Aquino International Airport Rehabilitation Project. The Transportation Department says that was only half of the expected eight bidders. The applicants include a consortium made up of Philippine conglomerates such as Ayala, Aboitiz, and JG Summit. Lucio Cos Cosco Capital is also part of a consortium eyeing to secure the project. Also submitting bids, India's GMR Group and San Miguel Corporation. The builder of the new airport in Bulacan, now Transportation Chief Jaime Bautista, says the winning bidder will be announced in the first quarter of next year.
In the last few days, we are in the average 145,000 passengers per day. And we're expecting that this airport, when turned over to the private sector, will increase capacity up to 60 million passengers per annum.
Philippine police doubled down on their crackdown against illegal firecracker sellers ahead of the New Year revelry. This comes as the number of firecracker-related incidents in the country rises. Raya Capulong reports.
This man was carrying a box of firecrackers that he was selling online when he was arrested in an entrapment operation by the PNP's anti-cybercrime group in Caloocan City. When he accepted the marked money, he was immediately arrested and handcuffed. In another operation in the same city, another man selling firecrackers online was also arrested. According to the PNP ACG, selling any kind of firecrackers online is illegal as it can only be purchased from licensed stores.
Pagka magbebenta ka ng paputok sa physical, eh kailangan may permit ka. Lahat ng sa BFP, sa PNP, sa local. Dahil ang tinitignan natin yung protection ng mga tao na bibili ito at saka yung mga nagbebenta. So, bawal po talaga ang magbenta ng paputok sa online.
The PNP also warned that aside from those selling firecrackers online, the buyers and even those who will deliver them may face imprisonment and fines.
For any person who would be caught in possession, using, manufacturing, or prohibited firecrackers and other pyrotechnic devices that was declared prohibited under the law can be penalized for imprisonment of not less than 6 months but not more than 1 year at a corresponding penalty of not less than 20,000 but not more than 30,000.
The two suspects are now in jail. The PNP admits that apprehending those who violate laws online is a challenge. This is why authorities are appealing to the public for their cooperation and report anyone selling firecrackers online or committing other crimes using social media platforms.
Kung ang gawain ay alam nilang illegal, gagawa sila ng fake account using their Facebook or any social media account. Siyempre, ang huhulihin ng pulis dyan kung sino yung kausap nila at nagbebenta ng mga paputok.
Meanwhile, the Department of Trade and Industry advised the public to be cautious when buying firecrackers. The DTI says sellers should have a license from the PNP and the product should carry the Philippine Standard mark. Consumers should also ensure that the items they purchased are included in the list of legal fireworks and firecrackers available on the DTI website.
Kada manufacturer na merong lisensya, meron lang specific models na pwede silang i-manufacture at ibenta. Mas maganda po, i-check natin yung ano yung bawal ng PNP at saka kung ano yung pinayagan ng DTI.
The DTI also says imported firecrackers and fireworks are also prohibited. Rayo Capulong, ABS-CBN News.
Three of the Philippines' biggest business organizations set to launch a massive job creation campaign in 2024. Their target? To provide 1 million jobs in a year. Speaking to state news agency PNA, Sergio Ortiz Luis Jr., the president of employers group ECOP, said the campaign is being jointly pursued with the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and the Philippine Exporters Confederation. Under Project Jobs, job fairs, and a digital platform informing job seekers how to participate in the program will be established. Ortiz Luis said the campaign will also help employees gain access to qualified workers. Speaking of AI now, a Philippine House lawmaker seeks to regulate the use of artificial intelligence in the labor industry. Quezon City Representative Juan Carlos Arjo Ataide filed House Bill 9448. Now it bans the use of AI or automated systems to replace human workers unless an equivalent alternative employment opportunity is made available. It also prevents employers from making decisions based solely on recommendations or results generated by AI. The bill, though, won't apply to industries or positions where AI is deemed necessary for safety, efficiency, or the overall benefit of society. The Philippine Trade Department urges businesses in the e-commerce industry to start preparing for the implementation of the Internet Transactions Act of 2023. Now, the new law, signed earlier this month, aims at regulating the country's e-commerce industry by protecting both consumers and businesses through detailed regulatory guidelines. The DTI says the legislation has an 18-month transition period, and businesses should use that time to change their business models in adherence to the law.
There's a transition. They need to revise the way they do things, especially in their rules of the platform. Remember, the law requires each merchant in the platform to make sure that they have the name, address, telephone number, that they have licenses.
It's huge.
Right?
Yeah.
So now we need to give the platform some time to make sure that the merchants inside the platform actually do have all of this information.
The International Monetary Fund says the Philippines is showing progress in its bid to get out of the so-called gray list of global dirty money watchdog. In its December 15 country report, the IMF noted, while more work needs to be done, the Philippines is continuously addressing deficiencies. The Financial Action Task Force in 2021 placed the Philippines back on its gray list, saying the country had yet to address 8 of the 18 deficiencies in controlling anti-money laundering and combating terrorism financing. Philippine authorities have committed to complete all action items and exit the list by early 2024. Debts paid by the Marcos administration hit 1.48 trillion as of end October. The Treasury Bureau reports the government exceeded last year's debt payments by 59%. Now, the payments accounted for about 95% of the programmed debt payments for 2023. As of October, the country's total debt is at 14.48 trillion pesos. Things are heating up in Argentina's police and demonstrators clashed during an anti-government protest in Buenos Aires. At least 6 people were detained Wednesday, according to local media. The demonstrators are protesting against some 300 austere measures presented last week by President Javier Milei to deregulate the South American country's economy. This as it grapples with triple-digit inflation. Despite the ongoing protests, Milei further unveiled more measures to Congress for review. Over in Mexico, top U.S. and Mexican officials hold talks as a growing migration crisis causes chaos on their shared border. A delegation led by U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken met with Mexican officials Wednesday to discuss ways to drive down numbers of migrants crossing into the U.S. The talks come as thousands of migrants continue their days-long march to the U.S. in an attempt to escape violence and poverty. The number of people crossing from Colombia and Central America topped 500,000 this year, doubling last year's record.